Alright, this is the latest of our grounding sessions for 10 minutes. We're going straight into it, making sure that your socks and shoes are off, and we're setting our timer. So, come down into that squat position and put your hands and your feet firmly on the likes of the grass, the soil, the sand, or your mat if weather isn't permitting. So we're in that crouched position. I want you to make sure that we're going to maximize the benefits of our grounding session. And if you can do it in the morning, it is more beneficial to get that morning sunlight to improve your sleep as well. And sleep being one of the pillars of health, and that's why I talk about doing two at the same time. Your best bang for your buck. So the first exercise, we're going to come up in a stretch. Hand up towards the sky. One hand firmly on the soil, the sand, the grass, the dew. As we lift up towards top, get a good stretch on, stretching out the upper back, and bring it back down. Okay, switching up the hands from left to right or right to left. Okay, and try keep your heels sat on the floor if you can. Okay, the more skin we have in the game, the better. Okay, holding it there, bring it back down slowly. 3, 2, and 1. And again, we're going to go again on the first hand. But this time we're going to rotate around a small little circle for me. Okay, stretching out the upper back. Smaller circles to bigger circles. Small movements. Naturally awakening the body, increasing cortisol, reducing inflammation. We come down, slowly making those circles as we come back down towards the center for me. These are small little exercises that we can do in the morning, in the evening, or in the late afternoon, depending on when the time suits you. But it's so important to fit it into your daily routine. Grounding is one of the most natural way of healing the body. We're making those smaller circles that turn into bigger circles as you go round and round, coming down slowly. And back down into the center. We roll out those shoulders, rolling them out while still keeping the palms of your hands, the soles of your feet on the ground, rolling them out. And the next thing we're going into is stretching out the glutes. So we're going down into bringing, either staying in that plank position or with your knees firmly on the ground or the grass. So we'll bring it in, twist the body if you can, lie underneath just slightly. And lift your head up if you can. And take one deep breath. Depending on if your flexibility is here, you can stay in that tabletop position, or you can stay in that plank position, working a little bit more of the core. Okay, those are the three variations on this one. So if you can, we're in this position. Take a deep breath in. You'll be feeling it now in the glutes or the hamstrings come across the body. Different. It's in microorganisms, microbes found in the location that you're in, on the living material, such as the grass right here, if you're in the sand at the beach, you're improving your immune system because your microorganisms are not only found in the likes of your gut, but all over your body. So you can do this in different locations, would benefit you. If you're doing it on the grass today, if you could do it on the sand, or do it on the forest floor the next day, you'll be improving your immune system. Your overall health is what we're trying to improve here. That is a flexibility for any exercise that we incorporate in a new healthier routine. So we switched up the leg, we're now on the left leg, we started on the right. Taking those deep breaths as well. We try to move our shoulders just a little bit, feeling the muscles we intend as we take in those deep breaths. Switching it up, and what we're going to do is come back in and up, and you're going to put your hands out behind. Okay, you're going to either just stay in this position and slightly rest your ass on the floor if you want, or come up into parallel with your knees all the way to your waist, your torso. We're looking up towards the sky. Deep breaths from the cold air.
You're doing this in the winter months. Going into the lungs, changing up the body temperature. Which again can improve your overall sleep. To initiate sleep, we just need a reduction of a temperature decrease of 1%. So going from a hot to a cold is something I do recommend to help you try and improve your sleep. And if you can, and if you need to, and feel your flexibility is at a little bit more than it was the last day, and try and lift one hand up for me. If not, just stay down in that tabletop position. We're going to hold that position for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We drop down for a second. Take a little break, a little breather on the shoulders. Drop your ass to the ground if needs be. We'll switch it up with the hands all the way up towards the sky. Feet from on the ground for me. Hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. If you don't have the flexibility to lift your hand up in the air, that's fine. That's a tough enough position to hold for the 10 seconds. Work in the shoulders or just rest in that position. It's about pushing yourself and doing your best that you can on any given day. So we're going up again. Okay, this time we're going to make those circles. Smaller circles into bigger circles. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're going back down slowly. Taking a breather myself. Holding my breath. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And going back up. Breathing out through the mouth. Switching over to the other hand for me. Making those circles. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Right, well done. We're coming up now. And let's stand in position. Open your hands up. Go to the sky. We're going to twist. Slightly lean it over in one direction. Stretching up that side of the back. Loosening those muscles as we breathe into our nose. And as we touch the ground and we touch the back of our palm, again, we're getting the areas that we haven't had touching the soil, different types of microbes. You take that deep breath in, you hold and stretch for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Shake it out, roll those shoulders over, again, switching over to the opposite side, all the way up for me, leaning in. The left direction if you started on the right for me. And deep breaths in for 5. Hold that breath. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now we roll up the shoulders. Okay? And just stay there for me. We roll up the shoulders. Okay, good. And we rotate the hands out all the time for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, last time on this one. Over here, up to the right. For 5. Hold the breath for the 5. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Again, roll out those shoulders using the hands. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Last stretch, nearly there in our 10 minute grounding session. Over towards the left hand side for me. Get ready for the count. Deep breath, we're going to hold far. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're back down to that squat position. What we're going to do is have a 60 second silence. You listen to the nature as you're finishing off your 10 minute session. Well done.
That's the second of our grounding sessions done here today. That's most certainly going to be a great way to start your day and incorporate it into your routine. It's something that you need to do on a regular basis to gain the full advantage of these grounding sessions. Okay? Well done today. And we'll see you again soon. Stay tuned. Stay classy. Keep it organic.